Mama, Kela says she's bored and won't take a walk to the riverside.
Why is she?
She's not a woman.
Kayla. Mama. How are you doing today, Kayla?
I'm fine, thank you, Mama. Mama, how are you feeling?
By God's grace, I'm feeling okay. It's better.
Thank God. Mama, I want Gracie to take me to the stream so that I can hear the sounds of the birds.
Okay. Gracie, take good care of her, huh?
I will.
Don't be long in coming for lunch, huh?
Yes, ma'am.
Take good care of yourself. I know you won't abandon her like this to the rest of her life. Let your glory fall upon her.
Part of the road we can pass is that.
This place is very hilly and it's all rocks.
I just want to avoid ants from the other road. Let's not pass this place.
If you say so.
Next time, make sure you lead him properly, okay? And be more careful.
Don't just leave her just like that.
God, the Good Samaritan was right there on time to save my daughter. I mean, what was the need going out with a brother who can't lead you through the right direction? Huh? Kayla, I don't have any other child left in this world except you. Please, oh. Only God knows what would have happened if that man was not there in time.
Ma, you're talking too much. You know that you are not well.
Shut up. Who told you to lead her through the rough road? Is there no other road to the stream?
But Ma, Kayla is okay.
Kayla is okay. You are talking as if it was through your effort that she was saved. If that man hadn't gotten there in time, only God knows what would have happened to my daughter. Where is the man who saved her?
He's gone.
What is his name? I said, what is the name of the man who saved her?
We don't know his name, Mama. He didn't give us a chance to say thank you. All he did was to bring us home, and then he drove off.
Okay. Tomorrow, we will go to church and offer thanksgiving to God for saving your life. Kayla.
Mama.
Come and take rest. Come inside. Kwesi, pack all those things. Pack all these things here.
About.
The voice of the man who saved my life.
Where is he?
Don't know, but I'm sure he's around here somewhere.
Sit down, gentlemen, without you.
There is he.
Okay, see, take me to him.
He's driving towards us.
Are you sure?
Yes, sister.
Hey. Hello. How are you two?
I'm fine. Yeah, she's fine. We are from the church. We want to say a prayer for you for saving her life. She's believing for you all day long.
Chrissy, keep quiet. You know, you can go home now. I'll find my way.
I don't want them to pour insult on me.
She'll be fine. She'll be fine. She's a big girl. She can take care of herself. You can take care of yourself, right?
Right.
So, is it true you've been looking for me?
No, I wasn't. My mom asked me to apologize to you whenever I meet you.
Apologize? For what?
Well, for saving my life. You know, I never got the opportunity to say thank you. If you hadn't come, I'm sure I would...
It's okay. Okay. I mean, okay, oh, it's all right. I'm here. Okay? Apologize. I'm listening.
Well, Thank you very much for saving my life. Sir, please, are you a visitor in this place?
Me? No. I'm a son of this land. I'm born and bred. Right now, I'm around doing a project.
Okay. Well, though I'm blind, I have a very good memory in remembering voices, and I have never heard your voice in this neighborhood.
That's because I don't talk much and I don't mix much.
Okay. Well, thank you again, sir. I have to be leaving now.
I can take you. Yeah. But what's your name?
Kayla.
Kayla. That's a beautiful name. And your brothers?
His name is Crazy.
Okay, okay, Crazy. Let me take you home, okay? Just turn around. All right. Slowly.
Stand right there.
How are you, Kwezi?
I'm fine, Uncle.
I'm on my way to the house. Is Kayla there?
Yes, sir.
Look, I got her this cane. You think she will like it?
Wow, it's beautiful, Uncle.
Yeah?
She'll love it.
Beautiful.
Yes.
But how did you get this? Who gave it to you?
Uncle, sir.
Sir? Where did you meet him?
I met him along the road.
So where is he now?
He's gone.
Oh. Christy, this is beautiful.
Sister.
So, Chrissy, how does the sir look like? Is he tall? Is he short? Is he handsome? Chrissy, talk now. Okay, Chrissy. Do you think the sir likes me?
Yes, I like you.
Oh my God. Chrissy, you didn't tell me the sir was here.
It's okay, it's okay.
I'm fine, sir.
You alright?
Yes.
You like your cane?
Yes, sir.
You want to try it out? I can try it, let's see. That's it, beautiful.
Sir, thank you very much.
You're welcome. Okay, you come out and see. Right on. You sure you like the cane?
Yes, I like it. I really appreciate it. Thank you.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
But, sir, why did you get this for me?
Well, I thought the other one was old, you know, and I thought you needed a new one.
Thank you very much. Are you this nice to everyone?
No. Well, yeah. No, not really. I just thought you needed a new one.
Okay. Sir, please, can I offer you something to drink?
No. It's okay. It's okay. I don't want anything to drink. Right now, I'm a little busy, so I'm going to get back to work. But I'll promise you that I will come and take you out one of these days.
Thank you very much, sir.
You would like that?
Yes, I would like that. Good. Thank you very much.
You're welcome. Okay, so right now I'm going to go. Yeah. All right?
Wesi! Wesi!
I want you to take this money and do anything you want to do with it.
Thank you very much.
Make sure you take care of your aunt.
I will.
Okay?
I will.
Bye-bye.
Yeah. Like I said, I'll come back and I will definitely take you out one of these days. Okay?
Okay, sir. Sir, you didn't tell me your name.
Oh, sorry. My name is CK.
CK has no meaning, sir.
It's okay. All my friends call me CK, so it's alright if you call me CK. You're beautiful, you know. And you have a beautiful smile too. And I'm crazy about those dimples. I am.
So you're flattering me. And I'm sure you're exaggerating it because I very much think you have seen better, sir.
Maybe, but I'm not exaggerating. I think you're really, really beautiful.
Thank you very much, sir.
You're welcome. Okay, so I'll just leave now, okay? And promise you take care of yourself.
Okay, sir.
Take care of yourself.
Thank
and
you.
Be good. Okay? So you take care of yourself, okay? Okay? Right on.
Let me see you before I start.
So let me see you go. Hello, ma.
Hello. You are welcome.
Thank you.
You are welcome. You look
wealthy, and influential. Kayla is blind and innocent. Well, I'm not against you helping her. But if I may ask, of what interest do you have in her?
Well, Ma, I'm not an affluent person. I'm actually an orphan. I've never seen my parents before, since the day I was born. And all that I am today is because of a friend that I have in Accra. My father used to work for his parents. And when my father died, because of loyalty, they've been able to help me out. Coming back to my interest in Kayla, it's because I'm from a poor background. I know what poverty is about. So I'm just trying to help. I was helped, and I want to help her out. So I just want to give her a world of happiness. That's my sole interest.
Anyway, thanks for hearing that. And I hope you take very good care of her.
I promise.
Thank you.
Okay. I want to leave now.
Mama. Mama, is that you? Mama, is that you? Who's there? Mama? Who's there? Kwesi, is that you? CK, is that you? Why aren't you saying anything? Who's there?
Your only sweetheart in town.
Stone?
Yeah, it's me. You recognize the voice of your sweetheart immediately.
Stone, what are you doing here? I thought you were in prison.
Prison? Oh, that's a lie. I went to Accra on a business trip and these foolish town folks just spread a rumor that I was in prison. Oh.
Stone, please, my mom is not around, so I'd rather you leave now.
That's why I'm here. I know she's not around.
Let go of me. You're hurting me. Stone, please, I beg you. You know my condition now. I beg you.
I know you've not been touched before. But look, you wait and watch. You will like it. You see, I want to marry you. I want you to carry my baby.
Stone, let go of me, Stone. Mama! 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 Mama!
Stop, what are you doing here?
Mama.
I will shout to... Are you okay?
What is all this?
Can you please sit so I can mold an image of you?
An image of me? You kidding me? You can't even see me.
Why do you think people mold images of God even though they can't see him?
Because they love him, they cherish him, they adore him, and because they want him close by.
Exactly. See, that's the reason why I want to mold an image of you, so I can have you by my side at all times.
If that's the only thing, then you should have just asked me if you want me close by your side. I'll grant it. I'll be by your side every day. Is that the only reason why you want to make an idol of me?
Yes. And also, because idols won't harass me like what you're doing right now.
Oh, come on. Those little things I do just goes a long way to prove that I love you when I'm close to you. There's no harassment.
So can you please sit so I can start?
Okay, I'll sit. Let's see.
Resemblance.
Wow, this is amazing. It's amazing. I mean, wow, I like it.
Really?
Kayla, what's the matter? Why do you have tear in your eye? What's wrong?
Today, I feel so sad that I'm blind. I wish that God will open my eyes so that I can see this image I created of you. God, I really wish I can see.
It's okay. You'll be fine, okay? You'll be fine. Don't worry about it.
Is it true that you are seeing someone else?
Stone, I have told you so many times that I'm not interested in you. Stone, please stop harassing me because I am not interested in you.
Is it true?
Yes, it is true.
Tell him to stay away from you.
I can't tell him because I'm so much in love with this guy. He's such a wonderful person. He makes me so happy. He gives me light even though I can't see.
Tell him to stay away from you. If he goes out of order, he will live by my standing orders. No one crosses me and goes scot-free. Absolutely nobody.
Sir, this is a case of an acquired blindness. She was not born blind. There is a 50-50 chance for her to either regain her sight or lose it totally. If there is anybody who can cure such a case, it must be Dr. Asari. But presently, he's not in the country. He comes to this hospital once every 3 months.
So how can I find him?
You see, I really don't know his schedule of work because he's a traveling doctor. But let's just hope he will come here this week, okay?
Okay. Well, thank you. I'll stay in touch.
All right.
In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
I brought you here so you can make a wish. Do you have a wish? Go ahead.
I wish that I can regain my sight so that I can see you.
Amen.
Amen. Don't you want to make a wish?
I wish that your wish will be granted, that you regain your sight. Amen.
Amen.
In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Amen.
Amen.
Young man, I'm warning you to stay away from this lady. If you don't, I'll show you there's a ruler in this jungle. If you dare! Goodbye.
Who's that? Kayla, do you know the guys? Kayla.
Kayla.
Mom! Mom! Mom!
Eh? What? What is it?
Uncle! Uncle Stone!
Where?
Is that my gun? Is that what killed Uncle CK?
Eh? Where is Kayla? She's where?
She's
let's go, let's go.
Thank you.
Somebody help me! Somebody help me! Stone!
Shit!
Ma!
Kayla!
Mommy! Stone! Ma! Stone! Is that what
there.
It's me, sister. Sister, what happened to your left finger? Did you cut yourself?
Casey.
Yes, sister.
Where have you been that you left me all alone in the house?
I went to the market to look for a job to do, sister. Sister, where is Uncle CK?
He left to Accra to do something urgently, and he hasn't returned ever since. Kwesi, life has been very cruel ever since Mama died.
Sister, do not worry. Everything will be all right, okay? I bought you some bread and milk. I want to tell you something.
What?
I saw my mom, and she said I should come back home for her school, sister.
Is that so?
Yes, sister. Sister, I'm really sorry for your wound, okay? Let me get in there and pray something for you, okay?
Where's everything? you should just submit some reports.
When the cold hands of death snatched Mama away from me, and later you left town, I truly came to terms with destiny that I was really blind.
It's okay. I'm back for you now. I promise never to leave you alone again. But there is one thing I want you to do for me.
What is that? Tell me whatever you want me to do and I'll do it.
I want you to come and live with me so that I can take good care of you. I don't want anything to happen to you. Anything. I believe with these hands, I can protect and care for you.
But only those who are married stay together.
Come on, let's make this an exception. Okay? Let's make it an exception. In my heart, I know you will find the love and care that you need. Will you come and live with me? Say yes. That's a yes.
You know, I'm only accepting this because Kwesi has left. So, you'd have to go with me so that I pack my things and then move in with you.
Never mind, never mind. I'll get you new stuff. You know, I'll get you new stuff, okay? All right.
A road full of pain. Sunshine has come into my life. It's my happiness, the joy that you bring.
Enter the ambience of a new environment for the first time in my life. I can't see it, but I can feel its warmth.
I can assure you, you will see again. I can promise you that.
I hope so, because it is my wish that I can see again. So that I can see the beauty of God's creation. And I can see you.
You will see again, Kayla.
Have a seat. Sorry. And there you go. Oops. Can I get you something to drink? Come on, relax. Yeah, it's your new home now, you know?
From the results of the test and observations made, she will be able to see. In fact, no one would have thought of a possible solution to this problem a year or so ago. But with the arrival of our new laser machine, the root cause of the problem can easily be solved. In fact, I would rather say both of you are very lucky. Very, very lucky. Let's see. Okay. In the absence of any complications, I think she will ably regain her sight. Yeah.
That's good news. When can we have the operation then?
Oh, 2 or 3 days. It depends on the urgency.
We do want it urgently done. That's excellent news. Don't we, Kayla?
It all depends. Anyway, what I would like you to do now is you take her out there and make arrangements for her admission. And then we can do further tests and observations, after which we see what we can do.
Okay. All thank right. you, Doctor.
Yeah, you're most welcome.
Kayla, let's go.
What's her name again?
Kayla.
Kayla.
I know it's been tough for you that mother hasn't been around. I just want to know how you're coping.
I'm managing.
Managing. When you finally regain your sight, what do you want to see first?
You.
Me.
Oh, I'm blown away.
I'm just blown away, you know? And I can imagine us in our own world, on our honeymoon, and our kids running around in the compound. Just two kids, you know, a boy and a girl, hopefully, you know. You know what, I just jumped the gun. I should have asked you something that I haven't asked yet.
And what is that?
Sit up. Sit up. Look my way. Look my way. Look my way. Will you marry me? Is that a yes? Will you marry me?
Yes.
You will marry
yes.
me?
Yes. Yes.
Oh. Oh, I love you.
Yes.
Oh. I love you so much. I love you. I thought you were sleeping.
No.
you know today is the last day for your bandage to be removed, right?
Yeah.
Are you excited about it?
Very.
I'm also very excited. So what I want to do is I want to go home and freshen up. Clean up the house for your welcome.
Why do you have to go home? Is it really necessary?
Yeah. I mean, I've been around for the past 3 days. No shower, no nothing. You know, I'm smelling and all. You remember your wish? That I want to be the first person you see? Yeah, so I need to look good.
But I want to see you just as you are.
I know, come on. It's not a big deal. Just give me like 15, 20 minutes. Maximum.
15.
20.
Okay.
Okay. 20 minutes maximum, I'll be back.
Okay.
Today's.
You said 20, right?
Yep.
Okay.
20. 20. 20. I'll be back, okay?
Okay.
Today is the day that I have to unbandage your face so I can see how fast you are healing.
Okay. Doctor, can you please wait for like 15 or 20 minutes because I want CK to be around. I promised him that he'll be the first person I'll see when I take off the bandage, when I get to see.
So where is he?
He's just gone home to freshen up. So in the next 15 to 20 minutes, he should be here.
Father, I have a flight to catch. I'm traveling. And I need to do that today.
Doctor, please.
Anyway, I'll give you 25 to 30 minutes so that when he comes, I do my job. All right? Les, take note, huh? All right.
Okay.
And I'll see you later.
Thank you.
What's wrong there? Let's push this car here. Huh?
It's a little effort. Let's push the car here so I can go.
No, let me try it for once.
No, let's push it so I can go out.
Come. Let me try.
Thank you.
Young man, I warn you. Goodbye.
For me to bandage your face.
Doctor, yeah. Please, 5 or 10 more minutes. I'm sure he'd be here.
No. I just can't. As I told you earlier on, I have this flight to catch. I'm traveling, and I need to do this job because no one else can do it. Just get up, sit up, let's see. Sit up.
Doctor,
Kira, do this for me. Good girl, doctor. Beautiful. Be good. Do this for me. Sit up, mom. He will come. He will definitely come, all right?
I really want him to be the first person I'd see, doctor.
I know. You will see him. He will be here, all right?
Please.
That's good. Can you see? What is it?
Why the tears?
Akusike has been killed.
What?
Thank you. Thank you.